know, when it comes to Van Halen, everybody wants this Van Halen 1. Nobody really remembers Van Halen 3. Oh, but Van Hagar. Everybody shits on Van Hagar, and you know, I think it's time somebody stood up for Van Hagar, and I don't know if anybody ever has. And the thing about it is Van Hagar is not nearly as bad. In fact, I'm even embarrassed to put it that way, to say not nearly as bad, but I have to start from that because people hate Van Hagar so bad. But that's not even accurate. It's still fucking Van Halen. It was still fucking awesome. There is no defending whether it was bad or not. And I get it. I get it. I understand. About track 7, When Love Comes Walking In on 5150, I get it. When you go from Eruption and you go from that first album, you know, I'm the One, and then Love Comes Walking In, I mean, that's a tough moment, okay? And I think what happens is we let the emotion of that song, which it's a fine song. It's a fine song. Maybe not everybody's cup of tea. I mean, I'm the first one to say that in rock, maybe we've had enough love songs, okay? All right? But I mean, once again, this was back in the day. Maybe they hadn't had enough love songs yet. I don't know. Whatever. I get it. But, I mean, it's not like... Look, once again, you got Van Halen 2. And no, that's nowhere... That's so much better than From Lawful Carnal Knowledge. You know what I mean? So, you know, of course, this was David Lee Roth. And here we have Sammy Hagar, Van Hagar, and just to be perfectly honest, anybody wants to talk about how Van Halen went soft or wasn't it? This album's basically porn. It's frankly a little disgusting. For Unlawful Carnal Knowledge, fuck is what that for Unlawful Carnal. Yes, that's what that means. And which, yeah, okay, we all laughed at that. We all that feels fuck. But, did you ever stop? Track 1, Pound Cake. 2, Judgment Day, where he's gonna put it off till Judgment Day. You know, he's not that bad. Spanked. Call him up on the spank line. Run Around. I thought that one might have been relatively harmless until I started reading the lyrics. It was pretty raunchy. Pleasure Dome, In and Out, Man on a Mission, which, you know, it's a mission to fuck. Don't kid yourself. And then The Dream is Over, which is, I don't think about fucking, I don't know, and then he got Right Now, which I was down there like, do it right here and now, yeah, okay. And then 316, which I think was like a lullaby that Eddie played for his kid. So that and The Dream is Over, maybe the two tracks, and then On Top of the World! So, yeah, that's okay, alright. Gross. But, you know, you see that shirt back there, alright? That's from Balance. Balance was a pretty fucking kick-ass album. Now, like, I'll take Balance over From Unlawful Carnal Knowledge any day. It's got some, maybe not quite Love Comes Walking In moments on it, but I mean, it's got some pretty rocking songs. Now, and another thing to defend Van Hagar, if you've ever heard the song Balance, Don't Tell Me What Love Could Do, next time, well, you probably won't hear it on the radio, but if you could try to recreate an experience I had where you hear it on the radio and you're like, I'm going to sing along with this, and then you realize how horrible you are in comparison. Sammy Hagar fucking belts it out. He's a hell of a singer, and he sings a lot higher pitched than I ever realized until I tried. I was like, I had to stop. I was like, oh my God, my singing is so terrible. And, you know, okay, I get it. I'd rather Eddie be playing the guitar than the keyboard, but you know what? That's not Sammy Hagar's fault. Sammy Hagar's not the one. Eddie started off playing keyboard, from what I understand, and that's a lot of where some of his guitar technique came from. So, hey, if that's... And left walking in is the price of Eddie Van Halen developing his rhythm guitar technique, and so be it, you know? That's pretty kick-ass, and, that's a cool guitar. You know, Van Hagar rocked a cool guitar, and, you know, it's sad, though, because I guess nowadays even Van Halen is against Van Hagar, and Sammy Hagar is against Van Hagar, and that's a shame. They did have some good songs, you know. Like Evo 5150, Summer Nights, Dreams has a really cool guitar solo, and that's the other thing too. It's like, you know, no matter what Van Halen you're listening to, Eddie always fucking wears it out. I mean, that can't be denied on any. No matter what else is going on, his guitar playing is going to be awesome. In fact, I think. Even on this album, I think Soul released of any of them, and one nobody really thinks about with the other singer, Gary Cherone, Eddie wears it out on that album. And I think from interviews I read at the time, him and that guy, they were really good friends, maybe almost soulmates. Almost, it may have scared Eddie a little bit, I guess. I don't know, maybe it's just because they didn't sell enough, but may have scared Eddie that they really got along well, because he hadn't always got along well with his other singers, but... Van Hagar had a good run, and there's a lot of rock, and don't forget, Dancing in the Streets, or Dance the Night Away, and like, there's a lot of, I see the dancing as being the same kind of thing as like the Van Hagar love songs or whatever. It's, you know, it's still, and you're still gonna rock, but you're still waiting to hear a song that rocks a little more. You know, if that's what you're into, for the people that would be against Van Hagar, for those types of reasons. But anyway, not that anybody cares, but Van Hagar fucking rules! Van Halen rules, but Van Hagar rules, and I think it's time for us to all be okay with the fact that even if we don't like all of Van Hagar, then it's still okay to like Van Hagar. Van Hagar rocked, man. That live album. Jesus, go back and listen to that live album right here, right now. That Van Hagar live album, that fuck is killer. Van Hagar rules.
Time is flowing backward to a life without a care. Tried to find a memory, but it wasn't there. Maybe it's something I don't know, maybe I don't care. Maybe it's something you should outgrow, maybe you should share.